Hello everyone, welcome to Vishesh Educational Videos. So in this video, I am explaining about disadvantages of graphical user interface. So before explaining the disadvantages, if you want to know more about what is a GUI actually, the link for that video is in the description. You can go through that video. So if you go through that video, you will understand what is actually a graphical user interface is. So then you can easily understand what are the disadvantages of graphical user interface. So if you are not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. To get the notification of my new videos, please click the bell icon. And after clicking the bell icon, please select all notifications. Right? And please don't forget to like the video. And please don't forget to share the video with your friends. So let me begin the explanation of graphical system disadvantages, that is disadvantages of GUI. So just I will brief what is a GUI. So GUI is nothing but a graphical user interface, you know that. So what is the interface? So interface is nothing but it is a bridge between user and the computer. If a user wants to use a computer, he needs some interface. If that interface uses graphical components, then that interface is a GUI. You can see here, this is an example of a graphical user interface where user can interact with the computers using graphical components such as icons, tabs, slider, status bar, menus, etc. So how a user can interact in GUI means he can use a pointing device like mouse, and you can select this graphical components by using the pointing device, or that means you can click the pointing device to select this graphical components, right? So to use a GUI, you need a pointing device such as mouse, right? So GUI has some advantages. If you want to know more about the advantages of GUI, again, the video for that advantages is also provided in the description section. You can go through it. But in this video, I am explaining the disadvantages of graphical user interface. Right? So first disadvantage is greater design complexity. What is the meaning of this? That means controls and basic alternatives must be chosen from a pile of choices, number again excess of 50. Don't get confused, I want to make it simple. Suppose if you want to choose a menu for the item that exceeds 50, it is not a good choice. You can't include the 50 choices in a menu, right? That is complexity. You can see here, this is the menu. You can see here, we have 6 to 7 options. That is fine. If it is having a 6 to 7 options, that is fine. But suppose if you want to include a pile of choices, like 50 choices you have to include, that is not a good idea. You can't include so much of options for a menu if you are using a GUI. That is complexity, right? You can't include each and every choices of menu. So while designing a GUI, complexity will be there, right? In some cases, you may not in a position to include all the design options, right? So that's why before only you have to choose the controls properly, right? If you don't choose the design procedures properly, then definitely users won't use your GUI, right? Wide acceptance is not possible. Only few may use. Not all the users prefer your GUI because of the complexity. That's why you have to make it simple. So to make it simple, the thing is complex, again it is not that easy, right? You know that. You can't, I told you, you can't include 50 choices in a menu. That is not a better idea, right? Again, you have to reduce the number of items in a menu, then you have to develop a menu, right? So here you can see number of choices in a menu are limited. You have to do like this, right? That is complexity. You can't include everything. And second disadvantage is learning is necessary. Suppose think that you are new to GUI, graphical user interface. You are an expert in command oriented interface like Unix or Linux, right? But you are not familiar with this type of graphical user interface. You are a first time user, right? So definitely it will be difficult for you. You have to learn, still learn the things to use, right? So because you don't know the meanings of icons properly, because you are a first time user. In fact, you don't know or you are not familiar with the use of pointing device such as mouse. You have to still learn the things. You have to still learn the meanings of icons to use the GUI. That's why learning still necessary if you are a first time user. That is another disadvantage. Next disadvantage, lack of experimentally derived design guidelines. So I want to explain this in a simple way. Lack of experimentally derived design guidelines means theoretically they can tell you can do like this, you can do like that, but we don't have a proof, experimental proof to tell that this is the way to design a graphical user interface, right? Theoretically they can tell, but we don't have any experimental proofs. Yes, some guidelines are available, but it's not in a big number. Very few experimentally proven guidelines. It tells that you have to use this icon for that. For example, you can see you have to use this icon for a calculator. You have to use this icon for a calendar, like that. There are few experimentally proven ideas are there for design, but only few are there. Not so much options are available for you. That is another disadvantage, right? And the next disadvantage is inconsistencies in technical terminology. In simple words, right? You can see here, this is the calculator icon that is used in Mac OS. Suppose if you go for any other OS like Windows, the icon may change for a calculator. This is inconsistency, right? For example, this calculator icon may different in Windows 8, or it may be icon may be different in Windows 11. Terminology is different. Terminology is different. So that is the disadvantage. Inconsistency in technique. You are not following the same terminology throughout the world. Differences may exist. If you are in China, if you are in India, again, right? Universality is not there, right? Again, icons may change from versions to versions. In one version it may be different, in the next version, updated version, that may be different. So that's why user has to relearn the things again. He has to shift to the next terminology. Getting, guys? Right? So if any changes are introduced, if any changes are updated, again user has to he has to rehearse means he has to relearn the things because of change in terminologies. Hope you are understanding. And the next disadvantage is not always familiar means whatever the symbolic representations you may use, such as words or numbers, right? You may be not familiar. For example, if you use a Roman number for instead of normal numbers, if you use a Roman number, some user may be familiar with that, or other users may not familiar with the Roman numbers. That is the problem. Not every user is used to symbolic representations. Only few may be having an idea. That's why, right? Not always familiar. Whatever the representation you are going to use, that may change. Some may know the things, some may not know the things. That is another disadvantage. What is the next disadvantage? Window manipulation requirements. That means window handling and manipulation. So if you want to close the window, or if you want to move the window, or if you want to drag the window, right? If you want to make changes to your window, these things are excessive. Even today, these things, window dragging, right? Or window opening, or window closing, again, window management, window handling is still excessive and repetitive. This wastes time, because see, even today to handle the window, again, we have to click this icon, we have to minimize, we have to click this, we have to, for maximizing, we have to click this, for closing, we have to click the red icon, like that. So even today, right, we are doing some excessive techniques. Instead of providing three buttons here, right, I may provide a single button for doing all the tasks, like that. Window manipulation technique is still excessive, repetitive. Same thing you may repeat again. Suppose if you open 3 to 4 windows simultaneously, for all the windows you have to repeat the same things. To close the one window, same operation. Again, to close the second window, you have to use the same operation. That is repetitive. That's why. So that is the disadvantage. And production limitations is another disadvantage. What is that? The number of symbols that can be clearly produced using today's technology is still limited. So you can't use different types of symbols for each and every tasks. What are the types of symbols you are using in GUI today? The symbols are limited. For example, see, for each and everything, I can't develop icons like this. Even today, this type of icons are limited. For every task, I can't produce icons like this. Only for important things I can produce, or only for important task I can produce icons like this. Getting? So, one second, yeah. So, production limitations. You can't produce so much of icons with this today's technology, with the available technology. Getting? And next disadvantage is few tested icons exist. That means icon must be researched, designed, tested, and then introduced into the marketplace. So before introducing the icons to the user, you have to research it first, you have to design, then you have to design, then you have to test the icons. For example, so these icons are not introduced to the user at a shot. No, before introducing these icons, they did the lot of research and they tested the icons. After that only, they introduced these icons to the user. Getting? So, this type of tested icons are very less. Yes, tested icons are there, but, right? But these icons are very less. But if you don't test these icons, what is the problem? The consequences of poor or improper design will be confusion and lower productivity for users. If you are not going to test the icon properly, it will lead to the confusion for the user. Definitely he will get confused. That's why, right? You have to properly design and test the icons before introducing into the marketplace. That is, before introducing the icons into the user, you have to test them, you have to then introduce. Next disadvantage, inefficient for touch typist. Obviously, if you are a good typist, if you are an experienced typist, definitely it will be difficult for you to use a graphical user interface, because typists don't use pointing devices more. But in GUI, rather than the keyboard, we prefer pointing device more. That's why if you are an experienced typist, definitely this type of interface, GUI, that is GUI, is not suitable for you. That is another disadvantage. Next disadvantage, not always the preferred style of interaction. That means not all users prefer a pure iconic interface. User may also prefer alternatives like textual captions. So as a user, some users may like iconic interface, some users may like GUI, some user may still prefer the command oriented interactions only. I'm not going to force the user to use the GUI only. If you take 100 people, 50 may still interested in command oriented interface, 50 may still interested in GUI. So not always preferred style of interaction. I can't force anybody to use GUI. It's their choice. Their preferences may vary, user preferences may vary. Some may prefer command oriented interface, some may prefer graphics oriented interface. That is the disadvantage. And the next disadvantage, not always fastest style of interaction. Suppose, assume that you are a clerk in a bank. For a clerk in a bank, they always prefer shortcut keys to do the task, because they have to do the frequent tasks. So when the clerk wants to do the same tasks frequently, what they will prefer? They will prefer shortcut keys. So if you use a GUI, definitely it is not suitable for that type of fastest style of work. This type of clerks, they prefer keyboard instead of mouse for doing their tasks, because they are using the keyboard, they may do their tasks very quickly using shortcut keys. So that type of users, like clerks in a bank, they may not prefer this type of interface. Not always this style of interaction is suitable, right? Next disadvantage is, may consume more screen space. So a listing of names and telephone numbers in a textual format will be more efficient to scan than a card file. Obviously, if you want to include, for example, so if you want to include 100 choices in this menu, this is, if you want to do that, you can do that, right? It's not a good thing to do, but if you want to include 100 of choices for a menu, you don't have sufficient space. You can't include all the choices of the menu because of the lack of space. So that is the disadvantage. May consume more screen space if you want to include all the options, like listing of telephone numbers or listing of menu choices like that. So this is not a good thing. This is a disadvantage. It may consume more screen space. And the last disadvantage, hardware limitations. Good design also requires hardware of adequate power, processing speed, screen resolution and graphic capability, obviously, right? So to do this type of design, to do a GUI of good quality, you also require a good quality of hardware, a a good processing power, a good speed, a good screen resolution, good graphics capability. You need all these things to develop a best graphical user interface. So not always this is possible, right? Because some may have don't have the adequate hardware to do or to develop this type of GUIs, right? Some people may not be in a position, right, to develop a GUI using this type of hardware, because when you need these type of hardware, obviously you have to spend more money. It's not everybody's cup of tea. That's why this is a disadvantage. Hardware capabilities are very much required. More hardware capabilities are required to design a good graphical user interface. That's why this is a disadvantage. So hope you understood the concepts, guys. Suppose if you have any doubts, please post your doubts in the comment section. Thank you for watching the video.